All right, guys, we're almost going to get started here shortly. I just got the camera covered up here for us, but I want to make sure that each and every single one of us gets the word out to everybody. We're looking to get started here in the next 3 minutes. So help me get the word out in all the group chats. Help me spread the link. Let everybody know that Mornings with Nano is live, okay? And we are on YouTube, so let everybody know. Hope everybody's enjoying this. Okay. Let's run it. So I'm excited. I'm going to get the call started here in three minutes, and we'll get it rocking. All right, fam, let's run it.
I just wanna dance with you, mommy. I'll put my hands on your body. Don't be shy, don't you worry.
I promise to love you, just let me enter you. Me and you, me and you. Too much sauce, too much juice. Dancing under the moon, baby. Baby, yeah.
I don't want it for no one. No, no, no. I just wanna dance with you, my way. I put my hands on your body. Don't be scared, don't you worry.
Let me grab my charger.
Too much juice, too much sauce. Too much sauce, too much juice. Too much juice, too much sauce. Too much sauce, too much juice. Too much juice, too much sauce. Too much sauce, too much juice.
All right, let's run it. Let's run it. Let's run it.
This house.
All right, who likes YC? Type of one in the chat box. Whoever likes the reggae, the reggae, the reggae. Right? Let's go. Let's go. I'm excited. I'm blessed. Yes, we're back at the OG house in New York City. Yes, 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 yes. Really, really looking forward to it. And I'm blessed and I'm excited. Thank you guys all so much for jumping on today's call. And, you know, always really looking forward to, you know, a new way to, you know, excite everybody, right? And I'm just super excited about Mornings with Nano and where it's going and where we're at with it. And I just know that every single person here is going to learn a lot from today's call. Because it's going to be big, you know, it's going to be a good call. And it's beautiful because every day we get a chance to, you know, grow with each other. Every day we get a chance to, you know, change with each other. And every single day is a chance for us to grow. It's a chance for us to step out of our comfort zone. It's a chance for us to, you know, become a better version of ourselves. And now this is the big question. All right. Yeah. I was like, it's not Miami edition. It's definitely New York edition. But I definitely want to know, this is where I test you guys. Who wrote their letter yesterday? Who started writing their story yesterday? Type story in the chat box if you already started writing your story for 2022, right? If you already started writing your story for 2022, let me see. Let me see who's the ones that started writing their story already. Okay. 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 I like what I'm seeing. A lot of people started writing their story. Right, Nick started writing it, Xavier, Holly, let me see, Damaris, Jessica, Liz, Bree Bunny on this call. Let's get it. We lit Algeron, Junior, Alexander, Claudia's on this call. Let's go. Josh, Vanessa, Dallas, my brother, Jacob, Jaden, Marv, Alexander, Vectors, Jose, Latrice. I know Latrice, right? Jerry. If I don't say your name, it's because I don't think I can pronounce it. I'm sorry. Zavia Miller. Bexy. I know Bexy. Natalie. My sis. Saul Almonte. T. My boy Kenny Lowe. Andrea. Let's go. Well, if you didn't, Chastity's like, what was the assignment? The assignment was basically... you had to start writing your 2022 story. For those, my boy Trev on this call, let's go. We live. If Trev is on this call, I got to turn it up today a little bit, right? But the assignment was basically yesterday, I started writing my 2022 story, okay? I took advantage of the day, you know, the day of December 21st of 2021 and December 22nd of 2021. Because those 2 days are very, very important days in the calendar for powerful manifestation. You know, it's a full moon. Like, it's just the energy in the world during that time. It is very, very powerful, and it can be used and it can be leveraged to manifest what you want. Not only did I visualize, you know, what it was that I wanted, but I also started to write it down. So, you know, for example, when you write your story, in a present tense as if you already accomplished it, okay? So you write your story as, okay, you already earning that $100,000 a month. You already have that dream car. You already live in that condo. You already retire your family. You already, you know, traveled the world to where you wanted to go to. You already paid off all your debt. Like, I had everything on it. Like, I had credit score on it. I had debt paid off. I had retiring of my parents. I had the development of, you know, six-figure earners in my business. I had my dream car, my BMW M5 in the story. Like, really, really, like, tapped in with that story and just expressing a lot of gratitude for it, right? Like if it was mine already, because like I was talking to you guys about it yesterday, it was the simple fact that you have to get yourself to believe that that story is true. Okay, get yourself to believe that that story is true. Okay, it's very, very, very important that you guys do so. All right, so I'm gonna send out one last message and the Telegram, let me just send it out one more time. Let everybody know that we are live, guys, because I don't want nobody to miss today's call. Okay. Right under it. Under the microwave. Okay, here we go. Here we go. And boom. Okay, perfect. So here we go. We're ready to go. And I'm excited. Let me go live on the IG for the fam one time. I'm getting adjusted to the whole new IG thing. I'll be honest with you guys. Something new to me. But, you know, like we always say, we got to do things that make us uncomfortable so we can get things happening in our favor. So that's what it's all about. So we are truly doing things that make us uncomfortable. And here we go. Boom, Portugal time. Yes, and we are lit. Okay. So, you know, today I wanted to go over a very important topic, okay? And the reason why I wanted to go over this topic with you guys was because, you know, I was at Matt Rose's house when he did this training the other day. And this training is one of the most important trainings that, you know, he's ever done, right? I truly believe that it's an incredible training and not a lot of people got a chance to catch it. But, you know, whenever I listen to a training, okay, remember, Matt has his way of doing the training. I always take what Matt says and I make it Nano's way of it, because remember, we both have different perspectives of a story. We both have different, you know, journeys. You know, he's 7-8 years into his journey. I'm only 3 or 4 years into my journey. So, you know, my way of, you know, explaining the training is going to be the same topics. I mean, the same points, but it's going to be different stories in between, right? Because remember, at the end of the day, facts tell, but the stories sell. And he did a very important training called I Encourage You. Okay, the name of the training was called I Encourage You. Okay, and I want you guys all to understand that, you see, a lot of people let a lot of the struggles, a lot of the triumphs, and what the journey brings you down. Okay, and I know that, you know, a lot of this business can, you know, bring pain sometimes. It can bring sorrow. It can make you feel confused, okay? And if there's one thing that I will tell you about this journey is that it's hard, okay? It's not going to be easy. It won't be easy. It's not going to be a walk in the park. It's not going to be, you know, a layup. This is not going to be a layup, okay? This is going to be like one of those Steph Curry shots from half court, off the backboard with three people defending you hard. You know, like that's how hard this is going to be. So we need to understand that we gotta be able to put our hands and just really grasp the journey, okay? So I want to jump into some stuff right here, right? And there's something that I want to say, and I want you guys to put this in big capital letters, okay? And I want you guys to put this in big capital letters right now. And it goes like this. Don't waste your pain. All right? Don't waste your pain. What do I mean by don't waste your pain? You see, what individuals tend to do when they're going through tough situations, painful situations in their lives, right? They waste the pain, not knowing that you can actually leverage pain. You see, guys, there's two different types of people in life, okay? There's the people that waste the pain, and then there's the people that leverage the pain, okay? And we can all agree that we have gone through some painful situations in 2021. But we gotta ask ourselves, have we been wasting the pain or have we been leveraging the pain? Because you see, if you leverage that pain, okay, that could be the pain that takes you to the next level. All right? You see, guys, I told you guys something the other day on Mornings with Nano. I said, let this be the last Christmas, right? Trish, you asked, but leverage how? Let me give you a perfect example. I was talking about it the other day, Trish. Two Christmases ago, 2019, I was sitting at home. I think I was making $1,000 a month. I was completely broke. I was done for. I didn't really have much money. I was making $1,000 a month, which was like $250 a week. And I remember the pain that I felt when I looked at the Christmas tree in my house because I didn't have any gifts to give my parents. I didn't have any gifts to give my brother. I didn't have any gifts for anybody at the time. It was a tough situation, right? There was nothing for me to give because I barely had anything for myself. And I remember the pain that I felt because I had been working the business for 2 years. So think about that, okay? I want you guys to think about that. So think about being in the business for 2 years, okay? In that same year, in October, I hit chairman. I hit my six-figure rank. This was in 2019. So I'm in the business for 2 years. I hit six figures in October. So I'm excited. I'm blessed. The whole world knows. My mom knows. Everybody that comes to my house, they all know that Nano is a chairman in his business. He's making six figures now in everybody's eyes. But what people don't know is that I wasn't even able to hold that rank because I lost it before the end of the year. By the time Christmas came around, I went from making $10,000 a month to making $1,000 a month. But nobody knew. In everybody's eyes, I was making 10. Nobody knew what I was dealing with inside. It was one of those tough feelings inside. And I'm like, yo, what am I going to do? What am I supposed to do now? My whole business has fell apart. I have nothing. I have barely anything in the bank. And everybody's looking at me like they're expecting, like you can tell that everybody was expecting something of me. Like, we know you got money now, Nano. We know you're making $10,000 a month now, Nano. So everybody's looking at me that way. And I don't want to tell people that I just lost majority of my business. I don't want to tell people that, you know, I had an organization of, you know, 800 people. And now that organization is almost 100. I was broken. The pain that I felt was so deep. It was so deep. I honestly cried that holiday season. I remember, I can't tell you exactly when, but I remember crying because, yo, the pain that I was feeling, I was like, yo, why me? Why me? I did everything right, God. I did all the calls. I did all the trainings. I went to all the events. I posted on Instagram. I did the stories. I did all the three-way calls. And I could just sit there and I just like, yo, why me, bro? Why? Like, damn, man, this is hard as hell. I was so tired. I remember being so like, I couldn't even sleep at night certain nights because it was like, man, it was so hard. And I had two choices there. I had choice, right? I had my choice. Was I going to waste that pain or was I going to leverage that pain? Okay. And I remember that exact same time, around that time, I chose to leverage that pain. And I'll never forget it because I remember I wrote it in my journal. I wish I could go back in my journals. I have all my journals in the room. And I could go back and I'm going to look for it and find it. And then I'm going to come and read it. And I'm going to see if I could find it. But I remember I made a decision. And I said, like I told you guys, this will be the last Christmas that me and my family struggle. This will be the last Christmas that I don't put gifts under the tree for my family the way that they did for me. This will be the last Christmas that I feel this pain. This will be the last Christmas that I feel this pain. And I leveraged it. I got there and I said, you know what? Never again will my bank account look like this after today. Never again will I show up to Christmas without having a gift for my mom, my dad, and the people in my life that I care about. Not that they need the gift. I could have gave my mom a Christmas card, me writing to her, and she would have loved it. I could have gave my mom, you know, something simple. I could have gave my mom a nice little t-shirt. I could have gave my dad a $40 polo, right? It wasn't that. It wasn't the fact that I couldn't get him a gift because I could have got him something. It was about the fact that I couldn't get him the gift that I truly wanted to get them and that I truly knew that they deserved, right? Who feels me? Who feels me on this call, right? Type a one in the chat box, right? You feel where I'm coming from. So I understood that, and that pain, it got me. And I'm like, yo, I'm going to use this pain. Because we all know that our kids, our families, our close ones, our girlfriends, our boyfriends, our wives, our husbands, we know they deserve more than what you can give them this Christmas holiday. They deserve more. But because you don't have more, you can't give them more. And I know that's painful. And I know that hurts. You don't know how bad I wanted to give my mom a beautiful, you know, Louis Vuitton purse, right? You don't know how bad I wanted to give her that in those days. A nice watch from my dad. Something like extremely valuable, right? You see, guys, use that pain because look, all the pain has a purpose. Remember that. All pain has a purpose. Because of this pain, sometimes you can feel hopeless, all right? You can feel hopeless. You're like, man, I felt hopeless in those days, all right? But remember this, and I want you guys to write this down. A leader without hope has nowhere to take people. A leader without hope has nowhere to take people. That's the truth. So at the time, as a leader, I was being tested. I had a choice. Do I go through it or do I grow through it? That's the choice I had. There was two choices. Don't go through it or grow through it. Type in the chat box what choice you're going to make as a leader. You're not going to go through it, or you are going to grow through it. What are you going to do? I want to know. Because remember, we're going to grow through it. Absolutely. I hope so. Right? Because the thing is, as a leader, you know, sometimes we don't even get the credit that we deserve. Did you guys know that? That sometimes as leaders, we don't even get the credit that we deserve. Did you know that 90% of what we do as leaders goes unnoticed? And the 10% that does get noticed and that we do get recognized for, we end up giving away the credit. Think about that. People don't know the amount of things that I've had to go through to get to where I'm at today. 90% of it has gone unnoticed. There's people that don't even know that I've been doing mornings with Nano 2.5 years straight, Monday through Friday, every single day. You know how many calls I showed up on, heartbroken, in pain, in sorrow, that I cried the night before, and every day, you know what I do? I showed up with a smile. Smile, smile, smile. Nobody knew nothing. Because I understood that 90% of what we go through goes unnoticed anyways. And the 10% that we do get noticed for, we give it away. Think about that. When I do get noticed for it, oh, no, I can't take all the credit for it. I got to give the credit to Sana. I got to give the credit to Jasmine. I got to give credit to my leaders. I got to give credit to the Mornings with Nano family. I got to give credit to everybody. I take the credit away from me. So remember that as a leader. 90% of what you do will go unnoticed. People won't notice the early mornings and the late nights. People won't notice those things. They won't. 90% of what you do will go unnoticed. And the 10% that does get noticed, you will give that away. Because understand this. We don't get all the credit. But guess what? We get all the blame, especially when everything happens. You get all the blame. That's what sucks. When a crisis happens, hey, you get all the blame. It was on you, bro. You got to take all the blame. Because at the end of the day, you're the leader. And everything rises and falls on leadership. Isn't that kind of crazy how that works almost? That, you know, you don't get none of the credit. You know, you barely get any credit. And when you do, it goes away. But when there's a crisis, when there's a fall, you have to take 100% responsibility for it. that's when it's like, damn, bro. That's tough. That's a tough one right there. But that's what makes us, though. Because look at what happens. A crisis doesn't make a person. It actually shows what a person is made of. Remember that one. A crisis, okay, doesn't make a person. It actually shows what a person is made of. Think about that one. So right now, if you're going through a crisis right now, if you're going through struggles right now, if it's not the time, this is what makes you right here. When I went through that crisis in 2019, when I was struggling with the Christmas presents under the tree, that crisis showed what I was made of. God tested me. He wanted to see. He said, you know what? Let me see what my son Nano's about. Let me see if he's really about this. I'm going to give him what he wanted, and I'm going to take it away. See if he's truly going to keep pushing for it. Talk about a test, right? Talk about God giving his toughest battles to his toughest warriors. That's when I knew I was one of his toughest ones, right? That's when I knew. I'm like, I appreciate after I got through it and then, you know, I had a conversation with God. I had to like talk to him a little bit. I'm like, yo, I see why you did it now, God. I see it now. I see what you had up your sleeve. It makes sense now. My bad for doubting you. You know, you doubt sometimes, bro. You're like, yo, come on. What happened? You doubt it sometimes. You're like, yo, I thought you was there for me. I thought you had my back. I thought you had my back. I was like, why me? Why me? But now it makes all the sense in the world. It makes all the sense in the world. Now I see why I had to become that leader. He exposed my weaknesses, all of them. Because I built my foundation on sticks and not on cement. He said, I can't allow you to keep building this because it's going to fall regardless. So let me take it away from you now. Okay, and let me let you rebuild it now. And you know what? You know what's one of the biggest lessons I learned during that, though? And that's why even through the struggles and even through the downs, I keep it going, is that you can't stop doing your daily routine. You can't stop. You can't stop. Every day, I still prayed. Every day, I practiced gratitude. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you. I was grateful for my $1,000 a month at the time. I was grateful for my $2,000 a month at the time. I was grateful for my team of 100 people, 200 people at the time. Right? Ricardo said it. He exposed all my blind spots. Right? But guess what? Every day, I still woke up and went and did it. And then 2020 came and Kobe died, I remember. That was heartbreaking for me. That was a hard one for me to swallow. And then I remember we went to London. I went to London on my last dollar, bro. Never forget those days, man. And I was being celebrated in London for an accomplishment that I hit in October, but I wasn't even that rank while I was being celebrated. So I was up there kind of like just like embracing the moment. Like, yo, I am chairman. Like, this is my reality. And even though it might not show in the back office, this is me. And it was so hard for me, guys. That's the hardest thing in the world. If there's anything that's hard in this world, is that when people have an image of you that you have to keep, but in reality, deep down inside and in the back office, they don't know that you have actually lost that income, and that you're no longer in terms of that you're no longer that rank, so to say, right? So that was hard for me. That was tough, okay? That was difficult for me, so to say, right? Because it was like, you have to keep that image now. You can't change, right? Because you show your weakness as a leader. That's what people don't get, right? Imagine if I told people, hey, you know, everybody looks at me as, yo, that's my guy, Nano, bam, 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 so on and so forth. And now I'm telling people I'm back at $1,000 a month. A lot of people would have lost respect for me. A lot of people would have lost whatever credibility they had for me. Okay, so sometimes you got to keep that poker face. Silent. Just straight poker face, no emotion. Yep, that's exactly who I am. Doesn't matter what's going on in the background. This is my reality. I am a chairman. The numbers don't determine who I am. I determine who I am. Poker face, posture up, and you show up every day through the pain, till everything catches back up. And you just show up, and yep, this is what we're going to do. That's the play. Let's run the play. And you know what? Like I said, the crisis doesn't make a person. It actually shows what the person is made of. And remember, it doesn't define you, rather it exposes you. The crisis you're going through right now is exposing you. That's what happens. See all those days you slacked off? They caught up. All those days you didn't read? They caught up. All those days you didn't write your goals down? They caught up. That's what happens. You thought it was a game when I told you that it wasn't going to catch up to you. It'll always catch up to you. You see, all those days that you said you were going to do something and you didn't do it, now they caught up to you. All those days that you slacked off, they caught up to you now. It exposes you. It's going to expose you, fam. That's why I be scared to slack off. Why you think I'm scared to slack off? You think I know how it works? I know how this works. I've been doing this for 4 years now. When I slack off, oh my God, bro. I'm like, it's almost like you did something so wrong. You know when you do something wrong and and you don't want to come home because you know that your mom and dad are going to tell you. You know, they're going to tell you off, like, yo, you know when you get in trouble and you guys remember when you would get in trouble in school and your teachers will call your parents and you wouldn't even want to come home because you knew that when you came home, your mom and dad were going to literally, you know, just go off on you. Like, That's how I feel sometimes when I don't do what I'm supposed to do. I don't even, you're kind of like the puppy, you did something wrong. I'm telling you, that's how it be feeling. Take the long way home. Facts. I'm telling y'all, bro, I've been there before. And it's because of that. It's because I know that when you say you're going to do something and you don't do it, it catches up to you. Guys, we're not little kids anymore. We're grown men. We're grown women. We're grown folks now. We're adults now. Those things could slide when we were in our teens. That thing don't slide anymore here. Every choice, everything that we do counts now. Everything. For real, guys, don't slip. Like, look, we can't do anything about 2021, right? I get it. We slipped. Right? There's things that happened in 2021. We can't control what happened already. But what we can control is what we do in 2022. That's what we can control. That we can control. What happens in 2022. Because look, you slip up at the beginning of the year, that's going to catch up to you in the spring and the summer. Whoever's going through something right now is because of all the slip-ups you did in the summer and in the fall. The choices you made in July, August, September, they're showing up now. September, October. That's how it works, fam. I'm just telling you guys so you know. So you know, at least Nano told me what it was. Okay. So, and then look at the problem here, though. Look at what happens. So many of us, all right, we love to encourage others. We jump on this call, we jump on calls, and we're telling our people and our friends, like, yo, let's work, let's get to work, and yo, let's hit six figures, and you know, we're gonna go and we're gonna do this and we're gonna do that. And you love to encourage others. But you know who you need to learn to encourage? You. That's who you need to encourage. You need to encourage you, family. So three things that you say to yourself during crisis and pain, right? There's three things you got to say to yourself to encourage yourself during a crisis and a pain. Write this down. Three things. I am not alone is the first thing. I am not alone. You know what, guys? I used to sometimes think that I used to go through problems by myself. I used to think that everybody was going through the best time of their lives and that Nano was the only one going through things. Guys, I want y'all to know if y'all going through something, you're not alone, family. I'm with you. I'm here right here with you. Because, you see, leaders are afraid to tell others what's going on. Okay, so what tends to happen is, okay, you try to keep all that pain inside to yourself. And what tends to happen as well is that can become very lonely. Those moments are very lonely, guys. Type a one in the chat box if you ever felt lonely. Right. If you ever felt lonely during the struggle, during the pain, you know, it was like, man, dog, I'm here. I'm in this by myself right now. You don't even want to talk to people about it. You don't even want to tell anybody what you're going through. You don't even want to pick up the phone and call anybody. Like, you don't want to tell nobody. You're just going through this by yourself. It's just you, yourself, and I. Nobody else. I want you guys to write this down. You can't heal what you hide, and you can't fix what you fail to confront. You can't heal what you hide, and you can't fix what you fail to confront. the facts. You can't heal what you hide, and you can't fix what you fail to confront. Now, what I mean that it's okay that what you're going through is happening, but remember, guys, you don't tell, and I'm not saying go out there and grab a microphone and tell everybody in your family and tell everybody on your team that you're going through something. No, no, no. Let me tell you this. You don't tell everybody that you're going through something because there's people, right, that will laugh and clap that you're going through what you're going through. Remember that too, okay? Because it is a world, we live in a world where, you know, people, okay, might be happy to see you struggling. They'll be happy to see you down. They'll be happy because they see that, yo, I've been praying on this person's downfall and he's falling. And they'll be like, yo, man, I hope everything is well. But when they turn their faces, they're like, yes, yes, yes. He's going to quit that business. She's going to quit that business. I knew that business wasn't going to work for them. I knew that Forex thing wasn't going to work for them. I knew that company wasn't going to work. I knew you should have just stayed in your job. I told you it wasn't going to work, bro. You should have just went and worked the 9 to 5, bro, like I told you. You see? And you gave them what they wanted. They prayed for your downfall, and you gave it to them. People prayed for your downfall. People prayed to see you quit your business, and you gave them exactly that. That sucks. That sucks. You know how many people probably waited? There's probably people still to this day waiting for Neno to quit. They have no idea that it's never gonna happen. So I think I've already turned them into believers. I think at this point now they're like, there's no way Nano's gonna quit now. But no longer, how could you wait for Neno to quit? Neno's never been a quitter. Chastity's like, weirdo behavior. Sis, it is very weirdo behavior, but it's the truth though, sis. You know it's true. It's the truth. You know how many people wish I would have quit so they could tell me, Neno, I told you, bro, you have a bachelor's degree, bro. You're so dumb for wanting to go and do that, bro. Go get yourself a good job. Go make yourself $80,000 a year, $100,000 a year. And now I make that in crypto in 3 months. See how life works? You see how life works? I want you guys to write this one down. Got it. Write this one down. Okay. See how I had to think about it a little bit? Listen, write this one down. And make sure if you're gonna do this, tag me on the gram. All right. And those that were seen dancing were thought to be insane by those who couldn't hear the music. And those that were seen dancing, right? We was dancing. We were thought to be insane by those who couldn't hear the music. Did that go over anybody's head or did you guys get that one right there? And those who were seen dancing, right? We was dancing. We was lit. Bachata, salsa, reggaeton, the whole nine. We was dancing. We was lit, right? And those who were seen dancing, us, we were seen dancing. They were thought to be insane. People thought we were insane because they couldn't hear the music. They couldn't hear the music. They can't hear what we hear. They don't understand what we know. So that's why people think that we're crazy that we do this business. That's why people think that it's nuts, right? That's why your parents, that's why your friends, that's why your significant other thinks that you're crazy that you go hard at this business. They think that it's nuts that we run a business and that we run a business that doesn't pay us sometimes for periods of times. People think that we do this for the money. Look, look, look. Let me tell you guys something real quick. If you are doing this for the money, you are not going to be here a long time. If you're doing this for money, I'm telling you right now, you're not going to be here a long time. Change what motivates you. This is not for money. Okay. If it was about money, Mornings with Nano would have been stopped long time ago. I would have stopped Mornings with Nano years ago if it was about money. Because I don't get paid to do this, guys. You got to think about it. Like, if it was about money, I don't get paid to wake up every morning at 9 a.m. and teach people. I don't get paid for this. Majority of the people on this call, more than 95% of people on this call, are not even on my team personally. I probably, out of the 600 people, 700 people on this call, maybe 50 people are on my team. Maybe 50. This is for love, fam. This is for the support. Because if the goal is to impact, it doesn't matter who we impact. My goal is to change all of y'all lives, all of y'all families, break all the generational curses. I know how hard it was to be on this journey by yourself. I know how hard it is. I've been there before. I understand this. I remember being Dola, but I'm like, yo, if I can create an environment where everybody can come every day, Monday through Friday, and just hear me talk, whether I get annoying or not, you know, maybe my voice can get annoying sometimes, hear me over and over again, and hear me sometimes call you guys out on your, you know, on your BS. Sometimes it might get annoying, but at least every day, you know that you have somebody that's going to be there for you. It's going to show up for you, and it's going to do what it takes to make sure that you know what you need to know to get you to the next level. Because you know what? I've been there before. I've cried. I've shed tears. I've been heartbroken. I know what it feels like to be alone. I know what it feels like to almost throw in the towel. I know what that feels like. And it's hard. And I get it. But you are not alone, fam. This is a support system right here. I'm grateful for you, Tiff. That's my sister right there, no cap. Because remember this, bro. People prefer to follow a leader who's honest rather than perfect. People prefer to follow a leader who's honest rather than perfect. I never jump on these calls and tell you guys that I'm perfect, bro. It might look like it sometimes on Instagram that everything is perfect and everything is good, guys. But trust me, I've jumped on these calls and I let you guys know that we're going through stuff. I've shed tears on Mornings with Nano multiple times. It's just I'm a little stronger than some of you guys because I've been battle tested more than a lot of you guys. That's all it is. You guys see where I'm from. Look at where I'm at, bro. I'm in my mom's crib right now. Right? 3-bedroom apartment in Washington Heights, New York City. Okay? My mom, right? Takes care of old people. My dad is a cab driver. We don't come from much, fam. I come from the bottom, just like all of us, bro. I did it from here. This is where it all started from, fam. Like, this is where it came from. You know the times that I sat on these couches right here? I was sitting down, and I was having a conversation with Katie, and she caught me thinking. She's like, what are you thinking? Like, what are you doing? And I was just stuck. Like, you know when you get stuck in your thoughts? And I was telling her, I was like, yo, it's so dope because I remember the amount of times that I sat here and the thoughts that I had, and I was having those moments. I almost got emotional last night because I was thinking, I'm like, yo, look at how far we've come. I remember sitting on this bed right here, broke as a joke, nothing in the bank. And now we have, you know, we have crypto portfolios and we're playing around with 10K, 20K, like it's nothing. I remember those days when I had nothing. When my mom would walk in the room almost in tears because how hurt she was. And now we throwing around 10K in crypto like it's nothing. Like, oh, yeah, oh, 10K investment, yeah, let's do it. Another 5K here, yeah, let's do it. But in those days, we didn't even have a dollar to throw. I'm telling you guys, life changes, but you got to put that work in. We have to put that pain in. Okay, so that's the first thing. And look, guys. The good thing is that when we came to YouTube, you see, if it was on Zoom, I wouldn't have been able to keep this. I wouldn't have been able to tell you guys everything I'm telling you guys right now because the call would have been ended. So I'm glad that I can keep it going, but I'm only going to keep you guys no more than 10 more minutes. All right. All right. The second thing you got to tell yourself. So the first thing was you're not alone. Okay. So I want all of you to know on this call that you are not alone. You're not alone. You're not alone. Okay. Number two is understanding that this too shall pass. This too shall pass. Whatever we're going through right now, it's going to pass. It's going to pass, man. Because remember, most of the worries won't be worries a year from now. My worry, Christmas of 2019, wasn't my worry, Christmas of 2020. Because you know what? I went from being worried in 2019 of not being able to get my parents a gift to 2020 worrying about what should I get them because now I had the money. Look at how that works. Look at how that works. So what I was worried about Christmas of 2019, I talked to you guys about that pain that I felt about not being able to get my parents and my family what they wanted, right? That was the worry I had Christmas of 2019. Christmas of 2020, the worry was, what purse do I get my mom? What watch do I get my dad? What gift do I get my little brother? Things changed. Right? Understand that leaders look at these moments and not just go through them, but they grow through them. Remember, guys, we are never down. Write this one down. We are never down. We are either up or getting back up. Don't you ever say that you are down. I don't ever want to hear no one on this call ever say, yo, Nano, I am down right now. No. We are either up or getting back up. All right, fam? We're never down. We're just getting back up. It's really all it is right there. If you are on the way to success, there's no way that you are down. You know who's down? The ones that are not taking any risk. The ones that are comfortable where they're at. The ones that are not doing anything on a day-to-day basis. The ones that don't wake up when they're done sleeping, they go to work, they get home, they don't do anything. Those people are down. We up. Because even though we might be struggling, even though we might be going through some pain, even though things might not be the way that we want them to, but you know what? Every day we're still showing up. Every day we're still going. Every day, every day, every day, every day, every day, every day, every day. The tough moments will pass, guys. And just like the tough moments pass too, the good moments pass too, guys. That's the thing. Everything passes, the good and the bad. We're going to go through seasons. Guess what? We're going to go through it. And next thing, we're going to go into a season of amazing times. And we're going to be in a season of amazing times. And all we can do is just love and appreciate the amazing times while they're there. The next time, right, next time we go through some really, really good, amazing times, I'm going to make sure that I am the most present person in the world. Because that's what also sucks sometimes, is that we go through amazing times, but sometimes we're not present enough to accept them and really celebrate them. Be present. And then those moments will pass as well. And then we'll go back into some more struggles because remember, we're always growing. That's the thing, guys, is that because we're always growing, we're always going to be challenged. Always. That's what our lives consist of. All 600-700 of us on this call right now, you need to understand that that's what our life consists of, is consistently being challenged. And you should embrace that. You should embrace that we are consistently being challenged every single day, day in and day out. Embrace that. Because that's the only way that we grow. So understand that this too shall pass. That's the second thing you tell yourself. The last and final thing that you tell yourself is this. Okay, and this is for my believers out there. Okay. If God is for me, who could be against me? If God is for me, who could be against me? If your higher up is for you, if your higher power, whatever it is that you believe in, if God is for you, who could be against you? Remember, guys, as you grow as a leader, your tolerance for pain must grow as well. I've grown so much as a leader, right? It's so funny. I believe that so much right there. As your leadership grows, your tolerance for pain grows as well, right? There's things that I've gone through in the last 6 months that if I would have gone through it at the beginning, it would have really brought me down. But my tolerance for pain has been so much. It has been tested so much that I don't even feel the pain anymore. I had a leader of mine, right? I had a group of leaders. I had a group of people leave my business for whatever reason. And one of them was a really close friend of mine, family member of mine, everything. And I took it with a grain of salt because I understood that I'm like, yo, you know, at the end of the day, you got to love them on the way in. You love them on the way out. Did it hurt? Was it annoying? Yes, right? But I'll never forget the words that my mentor, Sean Murphy, taught me. He said, you're not a mentor until you allow others to walk away with your wisdom. That's what he said to me. He said, you're not a mentor until you allow others to walk away with your wisdom. And I'm the people's mentor, and I get that. So I'm not expecting people to ride with me till the end, right? I can't expect that. I got to let people set those expectations. People got to set those expectations. I've learned to lower my expectations for people and let people set them themselves. That's something I learned in this journey. Don't set expectations for people. Okay, because what happens is you set these high expectations for people and then they don't meet those expectations. And what tends to happen is that you get hurt because you set those expectations for those individuals. And remember, there's no such thing as getting your heart broken. You get your expectations broken. Your heart doesn't break, right? It doesn't physically break. What happens is your expectations for that person break. Right? Think about it in a relationship, right? If you're in a relationship, think about it. You have a certain expectation of that person, okay? And if that person, let's say, cheats on you or, you know, doesn't do what they're supposed to do, you get hurt by that. Why? Because you didn't expect that of them. You had a certain expectation of that person. So because you had that expectation of that person and that person didn't meet that expectation, now you're in pain because they didn't meet that. So what I've learned is if you want to avoid painful situations, okay, is what? Let people set the expectations themselves. Let people prove to you with their actions who they're going to be. And like Tiff said, and like Flores said, be connected to everything, but attached to nothing. Because understand, guys, if you're going to do anything that's worth it, be ready for people to attack you and criticize you. You don't think people attack me and criticize me? I've had people tell me that I need to stop doing mornings with Nano. Yo, Nano, you need to focus more on your business, bro. You need to stop doing mornings with Nano. I'm like, yo, yeah, crazy, bro. Like, you guys are losing your mind, honestly. But understand this, and this is how I'm going to end it. When you magnify God, you minimize your problems. When you magnify God, you minimize your problems. And that's the key. So understand that those are the three things you got to tell yourself. First one is you're not alone. Second one is this too shall pass. And the third one is if God is for me, who can be against me? And understand that you got to encourage yourself to go out there and be the best version of you. All right, fam. So if you guys got value from this call, type some 333s in the chat box. 333s in the chat box if you guys got value from that. Thank you guys so much. On right here, we got the whole family, all right, as well on the IG. So appreciate you guys. But look, guys, take advantage of this moment. Use this moment to your advantage. Like I said, leverage the pain. Don't waste the pain. Leverage the pain. And watch, your whole entire life will revolutionize. Okay, I appreciate you guys so much. I'm going to give you guys a quick prayer, and then we're going to go. Everybody bow your heads and let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for blessing us with another abundant day filled with your grace and filled with your blessings. You wake us up every day because we're just so grateful because we get to walk in our purpose daily. And today, you know, we talked about, you know, encouraging ourselves to understand what happens for us as leaders, and that all the pain that we go through sometimes, all of it has its purpose. And whatever struggles, whatever challenges and obstacles you put in our life, God, you know, we want to apologize if we ever doubted you. We want to apologize if we ever questioned you. We know that every single obstacle, every challenge that you put in our life is there to help us become a better version of us. It's there to expose our weaknesses. It's there to help us grow ourselves into the leaders that you need us to become in order for us to impact the lives that are out there that need to be impacted. So we understand that all the pain that we go through, God, has a purpose. All right. And we're going to embrace that, and we're going to use that to our advantage so we can go out there and help others, God. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you for the pain. Thank you for the struggles. Thank you for the challenges. Thank you for the obstacles. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Because we know that that's what's going to make us better, God. And we appreciate you so much. And we never doubt the path and the journey that you have us on, because we know that you have our back. We know that we are protected by you. And at the end of the day, who better than you to lead us, God, because you are the best leader of them all. So we appreciate you so much. We love you so much. And let's go out there and have a great rest of our day. In your name we pray. Amen. 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 All right. God heard us this morning. Okay. He heard us. And everybody that's on this call, he spoke through me this morning to all of you guys. All right. So I love you guys so much. Just know that I appreciate you guys so, so much. Everything that I tell you guys, remember, it's not from a place of how do I say it? It's not from a place of me trying to be too hard on you. It's more from a place of encouragement and letting you know that I'm here for you. I get it. It's hard. All right. But you need to have that big brother sometimes check you. You need to have little bro sometimes check you. Okay. I know how that feels. Sometimes I got to have my big brother Matt check me. okay, and remind me what's up. And sometimes it's my little brother that has to check me. He's right here in this picture behind me. Sometimes it's my little brother that has to check me and let me know what's up. So if you're on this call, just know that. Use this as encouragement. Use this as a way to push you forward. And just know that your life is about to change in the next few weeks, because we're about to take this to a whole nother level. So I love you guys so much. I appreciate you guys so much. We will be doing a call tomorrow on Christmas Eve. Just want to let you guys know that. No days off. Okay, Christmas Eve, we grinding tomorrow. So I just want you guys to know that. So those who want to show up, show up. We'll have a special call. And, you know, for those that can't, then it is what it is. But I love y'all. I appreciate you guys. And I'll see you guys tomorrow on Mornings with Nano for Christmas Eve. Let's get it.